FranLab. Hey, it's Fran, again at the big table. So, whenever I show films on my film archive, every now and then people are very curious and say, Fran, why was a film like this made? Who would have seen it? Are these for movie theaters? And the answer is no. The truth is that way back in the mid-20th century, there was a tremendous interest and a big industry of films that were made really exclusively for domestic use. And back in the post-war years, there were social events where people would watch movies. Lots of social clubs, like, you know, 4-H, the Rotary Club, the Lions Club, Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, churches, community organizations, they all had social events, and very often those social events, if it included a dinner, would include a movie or many movies. And so there were lots of companies that would supply 16 millimeter films just to be seen for things like that. And they wouldn't be purchased, they would be rented, just like video rentals in the late 20th century. This is a catalog from one of those companies. Our 43rd year, Ideal Pictures, the world's largest 16mm rental and loan film library, right, based in Chicago, Illinois, features industrial films, religious films, short subjects, the kinds of films that I collect. A lot of them were made really just for rental like this. In the back you can see just all of the offices just for this particular year, which we see from the stamp here, February 11, 1964. So 1964, pretty much right in the middle of the heyday of this sort of 16mm film rental era. There are 122 pages in this catalog, and they're broken up into different categories. Table of contents shows about selecting your films. Here are the basic categories right here. Feature price index if you want to buy them, entertainment features, budget features, Walt Disney subjects, Halloween films, Christmas films, order blanks, that's in the middle, serials, that's the old short serials, short subjects, happy hours, Terry Toons, Heritage of Freedom shorts, Reader's Digest films, Around the World with Children's Shorts, Selling the Sizzle Sales Aid. That's just one film gets its own part in the table of contents. Sponsored and free loan films and religious films. That's the basic categories. Helping you select films. Teaching films. Over 2,000 titles of modern teaching films are available from our Boston, Chicago offices, so it's teaching films. Religious films, all Ideal offices maintain extensive religious film libraries, so lots of religious films. Industrial films, Ideal offices distribute films for over 100 great American companies and associations. Okay, many are available at no cost to you. Entertainment shorts, entertainment features, Box Office Magazine, Motion Picture Herald, Parents Magazine. Okay, so these are all rating systems to let you know what's good and not. These are the pricing indexes if you want to buy films. So you can see some of these prices. This is $1964 dollars. You know, not cheap if you want to buy a reel. Much cheaper to rent by far. This is the basic entertainment features would be 16mm versions of films that you would see in the theater. You know, second run, third run films, usually older films. Sometimes they would be edited down and shortened, you know, from 90 minutes down to maybe 40 minutes or maybe an hour. Sometimes they'd be a color film, like a Technicolor film, but you get a black and white print of it sometimes. It would vary. But these are your basic regular films that you would get in a 16mm version. There are lots and lots of those. You know, nothing out of the ordinary. Johnny Rocco, Jungle Gents with Leo Gorcey and Hans Hall. So there's going to be lots of Bowery Boys stuff. Bowery Boys again. And of course, a lot of Abbott and Costello stuff. Jack and the Beanstalk. Yeah, you know, and, you know, You're in the Army Now. A lot of, like, 1940s, early 50s films to rent, and this is in 64. And then, you know, Walt Disney had a big influence. Even when I was in school, we used to get a lot of Walt Disney films shown in school. It's just they had a huge distribution network for their films. And, of course, the Walt Disney science films. I think Wernher von Braun was in many of them. He might be in all of these. But yeah, Our Friend the Atom, Man in Space, Man in Flight, Man on the Moon, Mars and Beyond, Eyes in Outer Space. Yes, but they don't say, but Wernher did a few films for Walt Disney. He might be in those. Safety films, Donald Duck and all. Again, very popular. How to Have an Accident at Work, one preventable accident after another. Cartoons, of course. Halloween suggestions. House on Haunted Hill. That's actually a pretty scary one. Invasion of the Body Snatchers. I'm actually kind of surprised. These are actually like real scary films. It's a classic. Kevin McCarthy version, of course. Private Eyes, of course. Leo Gorcey and Hunsall. It looks like they had like a Bowery Boys archive deal here. Of course, these are, you know, films that they had to pay very little royalty on, or maybe some of them not at all. Some of them are probably public domain. But again, Abbott and Costello, Meet Captain Kidd, that stuff. Yeah. Christmas films, of course. Yep. Hansel and Gretel. And these are the order forms that they would use. You know, you'd cut it out, put it in an envelope, fill it out, and, you know, you charge your account, ship COD. Short subjects. And of course, you really never would know what would be on these short subjects. You'd just be, you know, you'd take your chance, you'd order some short subjects, order a feature or whatever for your event, and you'd run them, and sometimes they'd be good, sometimes not. Happy hour programs, just $4 per program if you book 10 or more. So get 10 films for $4. What would you use them for? School, church, industry, club, shut-in, community groups. Yep. So shut-in would be like if you were sick, you would actually rent films if you were quarantined with something. Well-balanced programs of two or three popular short subjects mounted for your convenience on a single projection reel to package rates. So they would basically make up the program for you, just ship it to you, just rack it up, run it, and all the films are all put together. Perfect for your birthday party, story hours, noon hour, recreational programs, etc. For the occasions where fine entertainment is wanted. Yep. Yeah, some of the packages. Case of the Screaming Bishop, Zippy's Birthday Party, A Beep in the Deep. Yep. Dizzy Ducks, Roaming Romeo, Disney Cartoon Parades, and Terry Toons. It looks like they had deals with both of those companies. There are the Terry Toons. So yeah, Mighty Mouse, of course, Dinky, Heckle, and Jekyll, Terry Bears, Little Roquefort, $3 each, $8 for three, all in Technicolor. Not necessarily three strip Technicolor, some of them might be two color Technicolor, you never know. Here we go. Our Heritage of Freedom, 1964, so you would want to get your patriotic films. Declaration of Independence, Give Me Liberty, Old Hickory, the Monroe Doctrine Under Southern Stars, of course, Sons of Liberty, Teddy the Rough Rider, Lincoln in the White House, Man Without a Country. So yeah, you got your patriotic stuff. You've got Reader's Digest short subjects, children's stuff again. This is interesting. Here's the thing. It got its own mention in the front. Elmer Wheeler's Selling the Sizzle is one of these motivational films. I've shown some of them in my film archive that were, you know, made in the 50s, 60s, 70s. It was a big thing to make motivational films for businesses to show, you know, at your office to get the people who work for you to, like, maybe sell better or maybe do their job a little better, who knows. From Behind the Berlin Wall, question 7, film that I've never heard of, but a winner of 22 international awards, so it's got to be great. Concordia Films, you can't go wrong with Concordia Films, endorsed by leaders of every field, you got to see. Question 7 from Behind the Berlin Wall. Hours of Entertainment, home economics. Yeah, this is the kind of thing, you know, how to cook and clean and serve food and prepare food and present food. Yeah, I've got some of these films and I've shown some. Health and safety, again, these would be for, you know, businesses and organizations and such, just showing people how not to be stupid or whatever. Sports films. Official sports film service from the Athletic Institute. Oh, sound film strips you can also get, not just films. Travel logs are really big. Travel. I don't collect travel films, but they were very popular and miscellaneous. Story of Light, so it's kind of like some science stuff, Wonderful Jet World, some basic science interest stuff. I've got films like that. Okay, so you got the Salvation Army, and now we get to the religious films. The whole end of this catalog is all religious films. So, yeah, churches, synagogues, a huge kind of customer for film rentals. So, yeah. In fact, when you go on eBay, if you're a film collector, you're going to find a lot of religious films on eBay, even today, that people are selling. It's like these days, it's a surprisingly large percentage of the films that are available for sale are religious themed films, just because they made so many of them and they got into collections and people, you know, there are people who collect, you know, religious films exclusively. But yes, lots of religious films. And by religious films, I mean specifically Christian religious films. That's what religion meant in America in 1964, and pretty much nothing else. Although, as a concession, they do have, at the very end, the last two pages, not Jewish films. I don't think they actually say Jewish. It's all Israel. Portrait of Israel. It's strange. I guess they didn't want to say Jewish or Judaism. There was something about that. Films are available from the Chicago office and may be shown only in the following states: Illinois, Indiana, Ohio, Iowa, Missouri, Kansas, North Dakota, South Dakota, Kentucky, Minnesota, Michigan, Wisconsin, Nebraska, and apparently you can't show these films anywhere else. Very interesting. But yeah, that's pretty much the world of film renting in 1964. All right, well, that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Thanks too to all my patrons down on the Patreon, making all these videos possible, even one like this. So thank you, thank you, thank you, everybody on Patreon. And I'm Fran. I'll be back doing something else, probably lab related, real soon.
At the bench again.